and welcome to Travel in Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, also known as Dash N. Well, to date, we've already covered two complete lessons. That's four episodes. We've covered a lot of ground. So what we're going to do today is we're going to take a little bit of a break, go back and review some of the material that we've learned to date. I have with me in studio two foreign students who are living and studying in Beijing, and they're going to help us with today's review. You've been following the program the last couple of days. Thanks very much for coming up and joining us today. Maybe we can just start with a brief introduction.
你好，我叫白依兰，我是拉脱维亚人，在北师大学了一年半了。
Okay, so you're from Latvia and you're studying at the 北师大, the Beijing Normal University.
对。
我叫康云峰，健康的康，云彩的云，山峰的峰，我来自德国柏林，我是去年九月份来到北京的。
Okay, so you've both been in Beijing quite a while. You come from Berlin, you come from Latvia. I guess from Latvia, there's no direct flight to Beijing. How do you get here? It must take quite a while.
没有，太累了。拉脱维亚没有飞机直飞到中国，所以呢，应该在伦敦换乘。我在机场等了好几个小时，太辛苦了。
Oh, so from Latvia, you fly to London. London 换机 change planes, and then fly here.That must take the better part of a day. When you get here, you're quite tired, and then you have to line up to go through customs.
对啊，人太多了，应该排队，太累了。
How about going through customs or through the border control, 边检? Did you have any troubles? Were they able to speak English?
我首次来到北京的时候，我大吃一惊，因为中国的海关都很有礼貌，而且他们的英语也讲得不错，所以我办手续办得很顺利。
What kind of questions did the border control agent ask you?
他说，他问我你为什么来到中国呢?
Why do you come to China? And you told him?
我来中国留学。
Okay. Well, today we're going to go back and look at the dialogue where Huang Renhao and his family were first arriving in China. And we're going to see what the customs agent or the border control agent asked them. Okay, let's take a look.
好，这是我们三个人的。
你们是一家人吗？
啊，对。
您来中国的目的是什么？
我是公司总部派来的。
你们打算住在酒店？
啊，公司正在帮我们找房子，我们暂时住在酒店。
你们打算在中国工作多长时间？
公司派我来工作两年，他和报社也签了两年的合同。
好。祝你们在中国过得愉快。
哎，行李在哪儿呢？
应该往前走吧。
嗯。
You know, flying for such a long time is really tiring, and it's a little bit nervous going through border control always, but I always find the most nervous time is when you're waiting for your luggage, and you're wondering, did it make it or not? Have you ever had that trouble where your luggage just doesn't show up?
对啊，我下飞机之后发现我的行李没到。
So you've just flown like 20 hours from Latvia and you get here and there's no luggage. What do you do? What happened?
好在第二天就到了。
第二天就到了。
嗯，给我送过来。
Oh, got there the next day. It was like on the next flight.
对啊。
Okay. How about you, 康云峰? Have you ever had trouble with luggage or been really nervous about something?
对，有一次我把我最喜欢的吉他托运了。然后我上飞机的时候我很操心我的吉他会被破坏或者被丢了。
Your favorite guitar.
对啊。
Can you not take that with you or 随身携带？
一般不能随身携带，因为它太大了。
So you have to 托运 you have to check it in.、
嗯、
okay, but it arrived okay?
对，最后没有什么问题，它完全无缺。
Well, when Huang Renhao and his family are waiting for their luggage, there's one piece that just never arrives. 行李丢了 one piece is missing. Let's see what happens. Okay, let's go back to the dialogues.
我们是刚从美国来的，我们的行李少了一件。
请给我看看您的机票和行李票。三个人的行李，一共四件。
对，现在只有三件。
可能出现了一些特殊情况，您先填一张表。
什么原因呢？
现在还不清楚，等一会儿我会再给您查一次。您说一下那个行李箱是什么样的？
红色的，这么大的，
有锁，还有一根褐色的带子。
那个箱子对我们很重要。
先生，对于出现的问题非常抱歉。
希望尽快给我们一个答复。
您放心，我们一定会尽快处理的。先生，请留下您的联系电话。
电话？留表姐家的电话吧。
一有结果，我们就通知您。
好，那我们就先走了。
再见。
再见。
So we're out of the airport. We've got our luggage. The best way to get from the airport to anywhere in Beijing is probably by taking a taxi. How do you find the taxis in Beijing?
我觉得其实在中国打车很好玩，因为出租车司机一般很开朗愉快，待人热情，可以很随便地跟他们聊天。
Yeah, the taxi drivers are really friendly, and it's also a great way to practice your Chinese too. And how about you, Bai Yilan? How do you find the taxis in Beijing compared to, for instance, with Latvia?
北京打车又便宜又方便，在拉脱维亚打车太贵了，我不敢打车。
又便宜又方便， they're convenient and they're cheap. But you know, Beijing's a pretty big city and we have the 5th Ring Road and the 6th Ring Road. Huan Renhao and his family were here, they found that they were taking the 5th Ring Road, which is a big loop around Beijing. So in that way, it's not that cheap. Okay, let's go back to the dialogue and see what happened with him. Let's take a look.
先生，请问去哪儿？
明月饭店。
明月饭店在颐和园那儿吧？
对，离那里不远。我这里有明月饭店的具体地址，您看看。
哦，知道了。
北五环的入口，从这里能上五环。雪梅啊，你看，都有五环路了。
是啊，北京变化真大。
是啊，现在都有六环路了。
这儿是不是离长城很近？
没错，从这个出口出去就能到八达岭长城。你第一次来北京吗？
这是第二次，我很小时候来过一次。
那你的汉语说的可真不错。
谢谢，我现在正在学习。
先生，您是中国人？
哈，我在中国出生的，后来去了美国，已经好几年没有回来了。
那您可要好好看看，这几年变化太大了。
是啊。
请问明月饭店快到了吗？
快了，从前面那个出口出去往左拐，过了红绿灯就到了。
现在这种立交桥很多。
要我说还是少，多了就不堵车了。到了。
多少钱？
加上高速公路费，一共96块。
哦。
找您钱，别忘了您的行李。
嗯，谢谢，再见。
不客气，再见。
再见，
再见。
Let's take a bit of a break from the language lesson. Talk about the roads in Beijing. You know, most roads in Beijing follow a strict grid pattern, north, south, east, west, with the exception of the ring roads.These are expressways that circle around the city, like a series of concentric circles. Before 1949, Beijing was a walled city with 9 major gates. In the 1950s, the city wall was replaced with what is now known as the Second Ring Road. This is a major expressway in the middle of the city, which has now expanded far beyond the area of the original walled city. Until fairly recently, the Third Ring Road roughly marked the limit of the developed urban area, but Beijing has continued to expand at a rapid pace.Now there are 4th, 5th, and even 6th ring roads. Now in general, outside of the 4th ring road, or at least the 5th ring road, what you'll find mainly are rural areas, factories, and some satellite communities. The funny thing is, there is no 1st ring road. In my mind, the 1st ring road should probably be considered the road that follows around the outside of Tiananmen Square. After all, Tiananmen Square is the center of Beijing, but locals never refer to this as the 1st ring road. You know, one thing about taxis is that you never know where they're going to be in the city. Like when you've left a taxi, he could be the other side of the city, and next thing you know. So you've got to be really careful. You never leave anything in the cab because it's really hard to find them again. What would you do if you left something in a taxi? Would you know what to do? Where would you find them?
其实我真的不知道，因为我还没碰到这个问题。
Well, I'll tell you, the best thing is you call the 汽车出租汽车管理局, the administration office. Have you ever had that trouble, lose something in a taxi?
有一次我丢了我的手机。
手机 ，your cell phone. You left a cell phone in the taxi.
对啊。
What did you do?
我好几次给我手机打电话，但是没人接。
Did you get a receipt from the taxi?
没有要发票，所以没找到我的手机。
You see, if you had a receipt from the taxi, it would have the taxi number and the phone number and everything on it. You could tell what time it was, what taxi and everything. Remember that for next time. When the next dialogue we're going to look at, they had a similar problem, but they were lucky enough that they did have a ticket. Okay, let's see what happens in the dialogue.
先生，没记住车号没关系，你有出租车的发票吗？
发票？
找您前时给您的。
哦，是这个吧？
对，就是这个。您看，上面有出租车的电话号码，还有出租车的车号。
这么说，可以找到那辆出租车了。
对，别着急，我们现在就给出租车公司打电话。
哦，好。
喂，你好，我们这有三位客人，刚才坐了你们的车，可能有一个包落在你们车上了。车号。哦，您稍等，您跟他说一下吧。
哦，好好好。喂，你好，车号是 BAF123。对对对对。啊啊，是从机场打车到饭店的。啊，好的好的好的，好，那谢谢你啊。
车子怎么样？
好，他们得跟出租车司机联系一下，有了结果呀，给我们打电话。
哎呦，得等。
Let's take a tea break and talk a little bit about taxis in Beijing. Taking a taxi in Beijing is relatively straightforward. Taxis are clearly marked with roof lights as well as special paint jobs. Now, most taxis are red, but different companies sometimes use different colors. Regardless, a legitimate taxi should be clearly marked and have an official working meter. You should never have to negotiate the price of a taxi trip. Instead, you should insist on 走表, use the meter, or go by the meter, 走表. The only exception is if you're going to be traveling far out of the urban area or you're reserving a car for a whole day. For example, if you take a taxi all the way to the Great Wall, you might negotiate a flat fare in advance. There is no tipping for taxis. You simply pay the fare listed on the meter, and you should be given a printed receipt. The only extra charge is road tolls, like on the airport expressway. Even then, you should be given a receipt that shows the exact amount of the toll. If you ever have any problem with a taxi, just write down the taxi number that's listed on the outside and the inside of the car. Taxis are very strictly regulated, and complaints are usually taken very seriously. In fact, if the driver sees you writing his number down, that's usually enough to solve any problem right away. In my experience, the vast majority of taxi drivers are honest and hardworking. It's a very tough job. Okay, well, that brings us to the end of our review lesson. Today we've been talking about 坐飞机到中国来, taking a plane to China. Now, when your plane arrives, you get into the airport, what's the very first thing you do?
办理入境手续。
办理入境手续, take care of the border entry procedures.And then, you've got that, you pick up your luggage, 取行李, you leave the airport, what do you do?
你就打的吧。
打的吧, that's another word for 打出租车, 坐出租车, take a taxi. And remember, when you take a taxi, always get a receipt, in case you 把东西落在车上, forget something in the cab. Okay, thanks very much for coming to the studio and helping us with the review. Thanks everyone for watching, and we hope that you'll join us next time here on Travel in Chinese.